We are delighted to honor a young female artist in the midst of her professional practice and recognize her artwork full of visual delight and significant meaning. Paige, congratulations.
There's this idea that every action that we have in our life and every relationship is informing our presentness. It's who we are right now. I never really have a grand vision for what my paintings will look like in the end. Sometimes I'll lay out a little study or a composition, but I can't plan it super detailed because there's too much serendipity in the process. It's a lot of seeking in little tiny steps and not really knowing what the end is. I like that I just have to respond to what comes because it feels like daily life.
What impressed me about Paige's art is that even though it's abstract, when you understand the meaning behind it, it's very motivating. We all face challenges, and we may feel our life isn't going in the direction we'd hoped, but small daily steps in the right direction can make for growth over long periods of time.
Life is daily. Life is a lot of maintenance and a lot of like dishes and toothbrushing and that kind of stuff. And we are lucky when we get these little vistas of like, oh my gosh, like all this work is leading up to something, and we get moments of that. And so in my process, I lay down several layers of paint, and then I take a power sander and sand through it. And all of that texture and all of that sometimes not very beautiful part comes through. But it feels so reminiscent to just what it's like to be a person. Like you're making mistakes constantly, you're trying things again, you're readjusting, you're covering things up, you're revealing things. And through trying again, things get more beautiful.
Paige's work, it is injected with so much beauty, and I can really see the feeling. When we refer to her work, we call it a sacred geometry. Her work is full of her own spiritual beliefs in a way that is very accessible.
She is working with kind of an old visual precedent. They look like quilts, and she herself has a heritage of women who have quilted for a long time. So she's using these really interesting patterns, but using them to say really thoughtful messages. Paige entered fitting fragments into our 11th International Art Competition, and one thing that was wonderful is she responded to the theme Meditations on Belief. With her piece, she has some spots that are solid and sure, and some places where she seems to be working out color and pattern that mimics belief, right? That some things we know and some things we're still exploring. There's a lot of spaces in that process, but as those things come together, there's a lot of beauty in that journey.
There's a lot of depictions of prayer and people praying, and I can see someone praying and go, yeah, that's what it looks like to pray. Usually you're kneeling down, usually you're, you know, people have their eyes cast up or they're folded or, you know, but I don't feel like I get any new insights about my own relationship to God through prayer when I look at them. But I hope that someone can look at a piece of mine and say, gosh, you know what prayer feels like? Prayer feels like laying down 10,000 triangles day after day after day after day, and it doesn't really feel all that efficacious a lot of times. Then when you look back, you can see there's like little beauty things or little insights or little pieces of inspiration. There was a point in my life where we were really seeking some answers about one of my daughters, and I was just really like, it was just a really hard period of time. So I was only spending a couple hours, maybe 90 minutes a day in the studio. My kids would either be in school or napping. But she woke me up super early because she wanted to make a flower crown. And stupid, I was so annoyed. And I was like, you know what? Because I'm doing this painting where I'm trying to like really focus on her and focus on how I've been, you know, helped and carried, I'm just gonna do it. And it was just like a beautiful, positive experience with her when it was at a time when there were very few of those. So I named the piece Repeated Miracles because it just helped me see like they were small, but they were there the whole time.
These mother artists are amazing. Paige, she rarely delivers art to me without at least two children in tow.
Okay, I'm gonna have you help me paint that big one.
Lots of times my kids will start paintings for me And it started out as just a way to buy time in the studio, like, here, take this, paint it, and kind of make yourself busy. But there's something really beautiful, too, in they lay down colors that I would have never put together, and it's really beautiful as you sand them, and sometimes they leave really big blobs, and they get kind of gooey, and it's like a mess and hard to deal with. And all of that, like the gooiness and the beauty, is so like reflective of just motherhood to me, you know? There's just like good parts and hard parts, and it informs me. I can't ever not be a mom. And some of my favorite paintings have been the ones that have started that way.
I was told when I received this award that I was an atypical recipient. It doesn't usually go to a young mother, and it doesn't usually go to someone who shows up at the mansion with two children, one in pajamas and one in a princess dress, both of them not wearing shoes to check out the space before the events. But I feel like I also kind of represent many of the mothers who I believe are the beating heart of this state, who are doing the hard work of building communities, checking on neighbors, taking people meals, volunteering in schools. All of these efforts are continual and they're important, and sometimes they feel small, and I think that smallness can feel defeating, but I hope my work serves to remind us that they're important and they're beautiful efforts that really do the work to bind and stitch together our community.